Greetings, all praise King Haile Selassie, Jah Rastafari, each and every day. Yes, I tells the tale. I tells the tale of the warrior. And the warrior prevails through righteousness. The man dies, the spirit lives. So I find it necessary to communicate. This is the reasoning process. You know, many people on the island of Jamaica do not have access to internet because they know that they are dangerous. This is probably similar in other places. You know, the Pentagon is distributing internet access to certain cultures and leaving other cultures without. We must first recognize what are the methods that are being used against us. These are methods of warfare that people are under attack without them realizing. There are certain people on the earth that have modeled themselves after Caesar, the arch enemy of the Christ, and enriching themselves. It's needs no explanation. And they're using instruments of war that are unconventional. Smartphone device being one of these, television. I know how the story goes. Oh, you know, that's just the way of the world. You know, they want to make you believe that these things come about by chance. That's why they have terms like free market, to try to make people think that this is just, you know, a free-for-all, happy-go-lucky, you know, economy that everybody thrives. It's not true. It's just not true. The facts are evident. We don't need to wait for somebody to tell us what we can see with our own eyes. The communication channels, so-called governments, they function on behalf of a sovereign network. The world class. And these folks are the world class citizens. They have more rights than you, if you even have any. Because nowadays, if you even tell the police officer, I know my rights, that's grounds for you to be arrested. They are operating this occult where these practices are secret and there's an exclusive membership. So, what are some ways that these criminals are able to rule over others? As I've stated, I am trying to drive this point home that these technologies are moving in a particular direction. Whereas you may reject the chip, later on, they're gonna offer you a device. And it's not gonna look like a chip, and it's supposed to help you survive. It's going to contain the chip. And they're gonna want you to put it in your body. which then becomes their body, the beast body. And notice how the man says, we are one, 99.99%, and God is all people collectively, or God is through people. So this is lining people up for the ultimate stage. And if you do not comply, you become martyred. And a man doesn't like to just go and just take, kill people, because it gives them recognition for their deeds. And so man's method of eliminating those threats is in secret. And he's attempting to use the same threats as tools of his advantage. Whereas if he can find ways to provoke someone to act against their stated causes, then he can destroy that person's reputation, whatever credibility or trustworthiness they may have. So the man is working in this way. You could take examples. His Imperial Majesty, how did they attempt to fool the people, to make them believe that His Majesty had taken $1 billion to Switzerland, The propaganda, when you look at it, if you go to a country where the people are not necessarily uneducated, they just have traditional methods of livelihood, and these forms of witchcraft come in the shape of language, for example, art, to captivate the minds of people. And yet if you look at those cultures that have lived separate from this devil's rule, the propaganda is so elementary that you would think, if somebody drew this piece of paper out of an airplane and expected me to believe it, they're fooling themselves. But that's because this is a different culture, different mindset. And so when you think about the propaganda with His Majesty, you know that it was directed towards particular people that may be inclined to believe so. And yet, you being, adept to these methods, are able to detect this fallacy. And so, let us take note It is real. And Babylon is tailoring their information towards particular individuals. For example, they're doing mapping, what I've called numerical sequencing, content classification, class content, so that they can determine how particular content affects particular individuals. So if somebody likes a video, or if they subscribe, or if they unsubscribe, the Babylon is going to look at what video, maybe even what second, you know, because somebody had to made a decision to unsubscribe. At what point did they make that decision? Well, they made a decision when the person was saying such and such. Yeah. They may even made a comment. But this is the information that Babylon's intercepting to be able to determine, you know, what content affects the minds. This is the witchcraft looking at doing a ministry report. I have the information. I have the work in a sequence of order. And so just dive in somewhat. This witchcraft is an ancient art. Some refer to it as sorcery. There's a slight difference. Sorcery being a witchcraft being a more general form. And so this art is perfected, has been perfected. The man didn't just decide, we're going to stop practicing those arts. No. These arts go, you know, thousands of years in the pre-Christ. And these practices have evolved. The man has found out how to affect the minds of the masses. When the pharaohs, magicians, came and did these miracles, were they real? Or was it just the perception of the minds of the people to make them believe? Their story of the temple that was desecrated, and the people would put the food out for the Babylonian god, and they would come in at night and eat it. You know, but Daniel caught him. And they, was it Daniel? Daniel. And so, no more did Nebuchadnezzar, you know, worship in that way. He was fooled, and the family was destroyed. And so these kinds of acts are done even in the ancient Rome to make people believe that those criminals are gods. They have this supernatural power. Therefore, they're the rightful rulers. Just stop, think about the lifestyle that these people are showing. We're seeing a different world when you look into that screen most of the time. Even when you're just watching somebody, like, let's say they have a YouTube account with where there's supposed so-called YouTube stars. You know, these people, they've got a team. They've got a camera person. They've got somebody writing a script. They've got, you know, most of the time. Like, let's say the Rusty Brand tapes. And so they're actors. I mean, they're not just waking up and going, you know what? I feel a certain way about something. I gotta speak on it. They're not saying, you know, those people are frauds. They need to be called out. No. They're saying, we need to get subscribers. We need to get views. This whole thing with subscribers and views is magic in itself, because it's making people believe that somehow, because somebody has more numbers, that they are more godly. This is a very Babylonian concept. You know, the Babylonians were the first to observe the stars, which is strictly forbidden in the Hebrew faith.